Welcome back viewers. In today's video we are going to check out the education packages. So in last video we have checked out the astronomy packages. In this video we will check out the chemistry packages. So the first application package in the chemistry section is Avogadro 2 and Chem 2. So let us open at least two applications. And I will open up another application. That is the Chem tool. Okay, so now what is Avogadro? So here you can draw the structures of elements. For example, carbon with 6 atoms, you can draw the structure here. So you can create the structures of different carbon molecules, and then you can display it to students so that they can well understand. Here you can build hydrogens, remove hydrogens. You can see here there are different ways. You can also create a DNA and RNA molecule here. You can create fragments of DNA RNA molecules. You can create the isotopes. You can see here the atomic coordinate editor is there, so you can create the isotopes. For example, there can be alpha or beta isotope of carbon, so you can create the letter structures, different things. You can see it here. You can create meshes of carbon atoms. You can show the covalent non-covalent bonds, the van der Waals forces. You can create wireframes out of the atoms and molecules. So it is a very advanced application. You can see it here. You can select by element. For example, if I click on select on element, you can select all these elements. This is the periodic table. You can select any of the molecule, then you can place the molecule here in this drawing window, and then you can create the replicate the molecule of that element, and then you can show it to students. You can show the different bonds between the two atoms in a molecule, covalent non-covalent bonds, the van der Waals forces, everything can be shown here. So I will not go into too much detail. It is not a study of this application package. Yeah, just I want to show you the different application packages that are available. Now I will close this. Let us go over to the Chem tool. So what is Chem tool? So this is to calculate the formula weight. Okay, so here you can see the carboxyls are there. So you can draw, you can choose any of this you can say molecular structure, place it here, and then you can find out the weight of this molecule. So you can, for example, if I select this template, okay, now what I have to do is I will go here, calculate the formula weight for this. So here it will be showing me the formula weight. You can see it here at the bottom, it is showing me. So this is C5H5 molecule is there. You can see here it has calculated the weights. I think this is weight or what. So we will have to go in much greater depth, but I am just showing you around. So this is the Chem tool to find out the formula weight for each of the molecule that you have drawn up here. And you can then clean up the drawing. So it will just clean up. So the weight will disappear at the bottom. So I will now close this. Yes. Now the next item in the chemistry section is EasyChem Chemical Structures Editor. So you can change the structures of the chemicals that you have created or the molecules you have created. So, and then you can edit the bonds, add the bonds, rotate the molecule, dextrorotatory, levorotatory, the different isotopes can be created. So everything is possible in EasyChem. So now I will close this. This is the GChemPaint. What is GChemPaint? while it is opening up, I will open another application, the GDIS molecule modeler. So GTK interface is there, display interface. Here you can create the different molecules, model content, editing, display images, symmetry and viewing, and you can select the atoms, select the atom level. You can select elements also, and then you can just make the different structures out of the elements, atoms or molecules you have created here. So it is similar basically, but different application, but functionality will be more or less similar. Now the next item is we have done this GChemPaint is there. Yes, now the GPeriodic. So this is nothing but the periodic table. You can see it here. The periodic table is there with the weights of the elements given here. You can go through it. I will not go much in detail. Then there is this calcium is there. What is calcium? And the other application is PyAMOL molecular graphic system. So calcium, what calcium will show is, you can see that the periodic table is there. For example, if we click on H, so it will show you the data overview for the hydrogen element. So what is the melting point, boiling point of hydrogen, electron affinity, electronic configuration, covalent radius, van der Waals radius, atomic mass, first ionization energy, electronegativity, oxidation states. Then it will show the atomic module. You can show the different isotopes of hydrogen that are available in nature, or some might be even synthetic also. This is some miscellaneous information regarding hydrogen element. Then this is the spectra of the hydrogen. It must be the visual spectra of hydrogen. Then there is some extra links to the extra information on hydrogen. So it links to the Wikipedia, Jefferson lab and the web element. So it is very informative application for the different elements of the periodic table. Now what is PyAMOL? PyAMOL so it will help you to create the different chemical or molecular or atomic structures, and then you can create the bonds, the valence bonds and everything. You can create a basically a model using this. So I will not know this, I will not go in much details, because let's see, and if I go in something, show you some detail, there will be more questions, and then we will keep on digging this. But you have to find it yourself. There is some homework for you. I will not go into too much detail. So we have completed the chemistry applications today. So I will stop the video here. In the next video, we will do some more review of some more applications for the pending section. So bye. See you in the next video. Bye bye.